Hello and welcome to all dear students. I am Mrs. Pooja Pohokar from FE Department PCCOE. Today we will be starting with unit number 4, polyphase AC circuit. In previous session of unit number 4, polyphase AC circuit, you have studied introduction of polyphase AC circuit, advantage, phase sequence and relations for star connected load. In today's session, we will discuss delta connected balance load and its phasor diagram. Here you can observe the difference between star and delta connection. In star connection you can observe there is a neutral terminal, whereas in delta there are three wires alone. No neutral terminal is taken. Let us now understand the concept of line and phase quantity in delta connected load. Now in the figure you can see there are two sections, supply side and the load side. Supply side is called as the line side, whereas the load side is called as the phase side. On both the sides, line as well as phase, there are two quantities, voltage and current. Like on the line side you will have line voltage, line current, and on the phase side you will have phase voltage and phase current. Now let us see what is line quantity. As we have discussed before, line means the supply side, and on the supply side you will have voltage as well as current. So there are two quantities, line voltage and line current. So we know voltage is always measured across. So we will connect voltmeter between R and Y. So we will name it as VRY. Second voltmeter between Y and B, we will name it as VYB. Third between B and R, so we name it as VBR. So what we have written here, VL is equal to VRY, that is equal to VYB, that is equal to VBR. Now why have we put this equal to sign? Because we are studying for balanced load. Let us quickly revise what is a balanced load. Now a load is said to be balanced when all the impedances, so you have seen three coils are connected, right? So it will represent the impedance in each phase. So when all the impedance have equal magnitude, equal phase angle, and when they are same in nature, then the load is said to be balanced load. Similarly, you will have line current. So what is the current? The current passing through any line is called as the line current. So in delta connected balanced load, so what are the three currents flowing in the three lines? So current flowing in the R will be IR, Y will be IY, B will be IB, and as this is balanced load, I will write down IL is equal to IR, that is equal to IY, that is equal to IB. Similar to line quantities, we also have phase quantity. So on the phase side also you will have voltage as well as current. So what is phase voltage? So the three terminals on the phase side are what? R, Y and B, where R of the phase is connected to R of the supply. Y terminal of the phase is connected to Y of the supply, and B terminal of the phase is connected to B of the supply. Okay, so when I connect voltmeter across one phase, one end of the voltmeter is connected to R terminal, second is connected to Y. So what is the first voltage? VRY. Similarly, second voltage VYB, and third is VBR. So I write down in delta connected balanced load, VPH, V phase is equal to VRY, that is equal to VYB, that is equal to VBR. Why we have here equal to sign? Because this is balanced load. Similarly, we also have phase currents. So current flowing through each branch of the load is called as a phase current. So in the first branch, current is flowing from R to Y, so I name it as IRY. Second, Y to B, so we name it as IYB. And third, B to R, so we name it as IBR. Okay, and again there is equal to sign because this is balanced load. Conclusion is, on the line side and on the phase side, what we observe is line voltage is equal to phase voltage. Whereas we need to derive the relation between line current and phase current in case of delta connected load. Now, what we have discussed in the previous slide, that in case of delta connected load, line voltage is equal to phase voltage, we need to derive relation between line current and phase current. We will be deriving the relation by drawing the phasor diagram. On the phase diagram, the reference values are phase values. So what are the phase currents? Phase currents are IRY, IYB, IBR. So we will show these three phase currents displaced at an angle of 120 degrees. Now, after showing these phase currents, we have to show the line current on phasor diagram. To show the line currents, we need to derive the relation between the line and the phase values. So how we can derive the relation? We can apply Kirchhoff's current law at nodes R, Y and B. So remember how we derive the relation? We apply Kirchhoff's current law at nodes R, Y and B. So you can refer the figure shown before. So in that figure, what you can observe is, first we consider node R. So at node R, what is the incoming current? IR and IBR. So summation of incoming current is equal to summation of outgoing current. So here that summation will be a vector summation. So what I will write down, IR bar plus IBR bar is equal to IRY bar. So as I need the value for line current, so I will write down IR is equal to IR bar is equal to IRY bar minus IBR bar. Similarly, when I apply Kirchhoff's current law at node Y and B, I get the respective equations. Once we get the equations for IR, IY, IB, we will show them on the phasor diagram. As we have discussed before, the three phase currents are displaced from each other at an angle of 120 degrees. Now to show IR, we need to perform the vector subtraction of IRY and IBR. So I know that minus IBR will be where? So IBR is here. So minus IBR, can you see minus IBR? And then you have to draw a parallelogram and show resultant IR. So IR is what? IRY plus minus of IBR. So once we show this IR, in similar way, you need to show IY and IB. You have the equations for IY and IB. Okay, so here we are showing it only for one phase. You can observe in the next slide, I have shown the phasor diagram for one phase. Now you need to derive the relation. To derive the relation, the first step is we draw perpendicular AC on vector OB. Okay, so it bisects the vector OB. What is vector OB? It represents line current. Similarly, OB bisects the angle between minus IBR and IRY, which is 60 degree. Hence, angle BOA is 30 degree and OC is equal to CB, that is line current divided by 2. Okay, so this is the first and second step, remember. Now third step. From triangle OAB, what you get? Cos 30 is equal to OC upon OA, where OC is what? It is IR by 2. Yes or no? We have written here IL by 2. IL is what? IR. And OA is what? Phase current. So IRY. So and cos 30 is what? Root 3 by 2. Put the respective values. You get line current is root 3 times phase current. Now everyone, just go through the derivation that we have discussed till now, and we have also discussed the phasor diagram for R phase. So similarly, I have shown here for Y and B phase also. So just go through this, and if you have any queries, we can discuss the queries in the discussion session. Thank you.